Thanks for coming in today. I appreciate you. I know it takes a while to get here, but I think it's a really important and productive time that will make your work on site a whole lot more fluid and efficient, and probably a lot less frustrating from what I've heard. It's important to us as a business that we have a sustainable model for growth and improvement that is built within the fibre of who we are, and not just something we get together and do every now and then. Basically, we want growth to be happening in small ways every single day. A big part of that is what we call the continual improvement process. It's basically a set of principles and procedures that every person in the business is empowered with that enables them to identify, flag, and implement change to issues that they see. Good? Mm-hmm. Yeah. So to do this, we have given permission and in turn asked for a commitment from everybody in the business, top to bottom, side to side, to continually be aware of areas in the business that could use improvement, that are not operating efficiently, or that you feel could just be done better, and be willing to engage with the issue and seek a better way, which is basically a summation of the continual improvement process.
Sounds good.
Any questions?
No, that sounds good.
No? Good, yeah. All right. So as you know, our business is all about making it easier for companies to exhibit overseas. It's all about being clever, efficient, resourceful, and also being calm. This is a service that we sell to our clients, and it's what separates us from our competitors. So because of this, it's important, actually it's critical, that we are continually evolving, improving, and bettering ourselves and our service, so we can continue to offer the fruits of this to our client. So to do this, we've based our continual improvement process around the Kaizen or Kaizen business philosophy. Have you ever heard of that?
No.
It's pretty cool. It's a Japanese, it's a tried and tested model used to improve quality and efficiency in business. So it's Kaizen, K-A-I, K means change, and Zen means for good. So that's what it's all about, change for good. So Kaizen consists of a few key principles, and as I run through these, I want you just to keep in mind the role that you play on our team and in what ways these principles may relate specifically to you and what you do. Cool?
Yep.
So the first principle is to take a preventative approach on making improvements before they become problems. Pretty clear, I think. But we want to empower and encourage you to flag an issue as soon as you see it. We would rather look into it and discover that it's not actually really a problem than for you to feel that it's not really that big a deal and it becomes a problem down the track. I know some staff keep a notebook or a file on their laptop of notes so they can just jot down things as they arise before they're forgotten. So it's a great way to do it, but up to you. Number two is focus on eliminating waste. Again, pretty clear, resources, time, material, etc. I think it's all pretty clear, but there's lots of ways you can be wasteful. Are we taking up too much space with our transport packaging? Are we requiring too many man hours? Can we package our items differently? Can we be more efficient with our travel and transport plans? So lots of things to be open to. It's important that we are as smart and as efficient in every way as possible. Number three, foster a company where every individual feels valued and actively participates. So it's not just the management job to identify and fix problems here. Yeah, you have a unique position in our team and you are a vital contributor. You'll see things and be tasked with things that I'll never see. And so you'll come across issues that I'll just never come across because of the position that you're in. So that's what's important, that you take note of these. Everybody in our company is responsible for its health and its growth. Number four, the status quo is always best, or never best actually. Pretty clear, just because it's the way it's always been done or that everyone else does it does not make it the best option. So this leads nicely onto the next point, which is keep asking why until you discover the real problem. Pretty clear? Mm-hmm. Yeah. You know this one, it's the kind of a key part of our business and how we effectively solve problems. Never be afraid to ask why something is done the way it is. nothing's off limits or sacred. It's all up for change. If it can be done a better way, then we'd love to hear about it. So don't just assume anything's done that way. Just don't just do things just because that's the way they've always been done. Six is collaborate across teams. So as you know, we are an open access business. There is no up and down communication channels. Do you understand that?
Yes.
Yeah, it's cool. The main reason for this is that issues often arise in the gaps between departments and staff. So if you notice an issue happening between you and the job billing process, feel free to bring it up with accounts. If you can start working with others this way, it's a really beautiful thing, and we can really get stuff done. So what we're saying is there's lots of things that often go wrong in business, which kind of aren't really anyone's responsibility. It's not quite the build, it's not quite the accounting, it's kind of in between the two. So it just sits there. So don't just let it sit there. Feel free to go up to accounts, and between the two of you, you could nut some pretty cool stuff out. Lastly, all decisions based on data. Look, you're a professional and you know what you're doing, so your word has plenty of weight behind it. But the more you can back up issues you flag with facts, then the better. Even if it's notes that you've made over a few installs or a trend that you have noticed and documented, that'll go a long way to help us to identify a problem and create some change. So they're kind of the seven main principles of the Kaizen philosophy, and that's what we kind of do for our continual improvement process here. Any questions?
No, that sounds pretty clear.
Yeah?
Pretty good.
Cool. I'll give you a copy of this to take home and read over. It will take a while to digest and probably even longer to become part of your daily work practice, but it really is important that you take the responsibility we're giving you seriously. It's a responsibility that we give to our staff to show that we value your input, your expertise, and that you are a key part of our business growth and improvement. And we trust that you will be empowered by the responsibility and that you will enjoy it and that you will enjoy the results that come from it. Hopefully it makes everyone's job here easier and better, and it's good for everybody. I'm sure you're aware that we have scheduled regular open input gatherings where people can discuss these things in a larger group and throw them out there to get some feedback. Have you seen any of those?
No.
Okay, all right, we'll get that out to you to let you know. We also have the online pin board. Did you know about that one? Have you seen that?
Yeah, I think I've seen it.
Yeah, okay, cool. You probably would have come across that. That's to use so we can put up issues online that you've noticed for thoughts and feedback. So the online gatherings just happen every now and then, pretty casual, but we just kind of ask that you flag some issues ahead of time and we give some people some time to think about it. When we come together, we throw a few of them out there and everybody gets to have a say in it, which is pretty cool. We get some pretty good change coming out of those events. I'd encourage you to get involved with these if you can, even if you don't have anything to bring along. Your expertise and position in the business might shed some valuable light on an issue that someone else is having, so it's worth doing. It could be an issue in accounts or in storage or in freight.
Yep.
What?
Yep, no.
Okay. All right, keep going. As I said, any time is a good time for you to get involved with continual improvement. So go for it. If you need any more clarification, have any questions or whatever, get back to me.
Sorry, Lion's in the background doing the weird things. I'm sorry. I'm trying not to. Lion's doing the weirdest things.
What's she doing? As I said, any time's a good time to get involved with the CI process here, so go for it. If you need any more clarification, have any questions or whatever, feel free to get back to me any time. It's super important that it sinks in, so feel free to ask any questions that you need to. My door's always open. And that's it. That's the continual improvement process here. So like I said, I'll give you a copy of all this. Take it away, have a read, come back to me. I expect that you'll probably have some questions, so ask me or anyone else around here. We're all familiar with the process, so not too scary, is it?
Mm-mm.
A lot to take in?
Sounds pretty clear,
yeah.
But I'm sure I'll come to understand it.
Cool, excellent. All right, thanks for your time.